Once you've downloaded and installed Media Pro, it's time to make the first catalog. You'll want to decide where you want to save these so that you know where all of your catalogs are. I suggest using a folder for Works in Progress, and inside that, making a folder for your catalogs. You should start with one single catalog and only divide your catalog up into additional catalogs as the need presents. Now that we have a folder to save this into, let's launch the application and make our first catalog. I launch the application by finding it in the Applications folder and double-click to launch. You'll be asked at this point to either run it as a trial or to enter your license number. If you've purchased the software and you have an activation code, select Activate and then hit the Activate button. If you haven't yet purchased it, you can run it in trial mode and you get a fully functional version of the software for about a month. When Media Pro launches, you should see something like this. You get a welcome screen that gives you the option to go ahead and import pictures from several different places, and a new catalog is created that's called Catalog 1. Let's set up and save our catalog before we do any importing, so I'm just going to hit cancel right now. Over here in the catalog, we see an empty catalog, and it's got this name in the title bar, Catalog 1. Let's save it into the folder that we've just made. I'm going to go into File, Save As, and then go find my working folder, and inside my working folder, we'll find the Catalogs folder, and let's save this as Master Catalog. There's another movie that's going to outline lots of preferences, but for the moment, let's just make sure we have this first one checked, which is that at startup, we're going to open last catalog. This way, anytime we open Media Pro, we're going to make sure that we're working on the master catalog. So we get just the one single window when the catalog first comes up, and I suggest that you want to open up the Organize panel so that we can see the folders that any images that are cataloged are in, as well as this other information that's showing up here in the left-hand panel. I also suggest that we probably want to go ahead and make the catalog window bigger so that we maximize the space that we have to work with. Now that we have this set up, we can start importing images. There are a couple of different ways that you can add images to a Media Pro catalog. We can go up to the File menu to Import Items and Files and Folders. When we do that, we can navigate through the file system of the hard drive and find some images and say, bring that whole folder in. So I can go find this set of pictures here, select it, and hit Choose. Those images are going to first come in with some embedded thumbnails, and as Media Pro chugs through and pulls out information from the pictures, we're going to see more information showing up. Let's open up the date finder and see what's happening here. You can see that as Media Pro works through these images and reads the date out of the metadata that the camera put in the original file, you can see it's counting these up and adding them to these groups that it's making that are based upon the day the picture was shot. I've opened up this panel at the bottom that shows me the progress of the import, and it counts this down as it goes through the whole set of images. Now that Media Pro has finished cataloging these images, let's do a quick change over here in this catalog folders area. I'm going to open it up just a little bit. We can see we only see the folder that these images are in and none of the hierarchy that's on top of that. That's because this is set up to trim folder hierarchy, and I can uncheck that, and you can see what we see now is the entire folder tree from that folder that these images are in all the way back up to the hard drive itself. Now the other thing we know is that there's lots of different stuff on the hard drive, but we're only seeing these 339 images. That's because Media Pro is only going to pay attention to the stuff you've told it to catalog. It's not showing you everything on the drive in the way that a browser would, like Capture One Pro or Adobe Bridge would show you everything that's there that it can read. Media Pro only shows you what you've told it to pay attention to. Let's take a look at another way we can bring images into the catalog, and that's just a simple drag and drop. You can take a single file or a folder full of files and drag that onto the Media Pro window, and you see the plus appear, and then when I let go, Media Pro is going to start to catalog all of these images. We can see over here in the folders area that because this folder is on a separate drive, we can actually see that whole drive and navigate down to the folder. And we can also see up here in the file type area, as it discovers new file types and catalogs these new files, we're going to start to see this count up. And we'll see that not only are we going to have JPEGs in here, but we're also going to have TIFFs and movie files. And again, by looking in the date finder, we can see the dates that these particular images or movies were created. Let's let this finish cataloging, and we'll come back and finish the movie. At the end of the process, we can see the whole set of images here. And if we move over to the date finder, we can look for images by particular days by selecting here. And if we open up the file type panel, we can see that most of these are JPEGs. There's a number of TIFFs, and then there's a number of movie files as well. We want to play those movie files. It's as simple as double clicking and hitting the space bar or going back into the thumbnail view, and we can see the movie playing as well. I find this process of cataloging a whole drive full of images to be a really wonderful one of discovery. So I suggest that what you do is make a comprehensive catalog of stuff that you've got on your hard drive, and you're likely to find a bunch of things that you've forgotten about. Once you've run through that whole process, then you really can get a much better handle on your collection. The last step here is to make sure that we save the catalog, and that way all the work we've done will be visible next time we open the catalog.